So where is she? That voice. I think I need to hear the rest. I think I've needed to hear this for a long time.
For years we lived in peace, and our little dunes were our own to keep. But the sands of peace are ever shifting. Years later, a plague came to the desert. The infested. Desperate, our people called out to the sky. Inaros! Inaros! But they could not wake him. And so, they were consumed by the ravenous horde. With all lost, the few remaining villagers gathered in the morning circle to prepare for the end, when suddenly, a storm rose about them. A colossal, spiral storm of sand, piercing the sky. The villagers huddled, trapped within the storm's eye, as the beasts charged them. In moments, the beasts were torn apart, and the infested plague was swept away, never to be seen again. As the storm subsided, the people ventured out into the desert, hoping to catch a glimpse of their savior, their beloved Inaros.
Get ready.
they found his glorious metal body, broken and still, lying in the sand. Did they mourn? No, no. They knew his spirit had returned to the sky to watch over them once again. They gathered his body to keep it safe from thieves and raiders. They placed the pieces within the sacred vessels and entombed them in secret, knowing that one day Inaros would reclaim his body and rise again. So now, my sweet Doom, you have no need of fear. Take these grains and keep them under your pillow. Inaros will watch over you.
Find extraction. We're done here. The story isn't just a myth, is it? Look at this sacred vessel, one of four, just as she described. And the challenges. You must prove your Tenno.